Hey, what's up? This is your color girl, Indigo Zuri. This video is the second part to our two-part series on pattern mixing. In part one, I showed you how to mix two similar patterns to achieve a smooth and natural transition. Today, I will be discussing the principles for mixing two different geometric patterns and providing examples to show you how to put those rules into action. So, you got your pen and paper out? Good. Let's begin. When mixing two geometric patterns, such as stripes with checks or checks with polka dots, the dominant color of your shirt should be the accent color of your tie. Again, it's very important to make sure you use varying sizes and spacing. Small stripes with large polka dots or large polka dots with small stripes. For the novice, it's a good idea to select a shirt with a smaller pattern, leaving the larger pattern for the tie. As you begin to become more comfortable with pattern mixing, then you may want to explore doing different things. Larger shirt pattern, smaller tie pattern. Right now, let's take a look at mixing stripes with checks and polka dots. First, I'd like to suggest that you expand the viewing of your screen. If you're not already looking at this in the largest viewing mode available, then you may want to do that in order to see the patterns better. And also, you will want to look toward the bottom of the screen. Look toward the bottom middle, actually. That too will help you to be able to see the patterns a lot better. Now, this first example is a navy blue striped shirt. The stripes are periwinkle. They are very small scaled stripes. The spacing between the stripes is small. Okay, now the first tie that I am going to add to this shirt is a navy blue and periwinkle checked tie. Now, the checks in the tie are small, but that's not a problem because the stripes in the shirt are very subtle. So, we don't have a problem there with tension or vibration. The spacing between the checks, that too is small, okay? So with respect to vibration or this being easy on the eyes, we don't have a problem there. This works. Where the problem lies is the dominant color of the shirt is not the accent color of the tie. The dominant color of the shirt is navy. The accent color of the tie is periwinkle. So while it works, it's rather boring, lacks flavor, and you know, anybody can do this. So let's take a look at this second tie. This next tie has polka dots, and the polka dots are medium in scale. The spacing between the polka dots is small. So we have a varying range of with respect to scale and spacing between the tie and the shirt. So that's good. Now, as far as the color rule is concerned, the dominant color of the shirt is navy. The accent color, or one of the accent colors of the tie, is also navy. So the tie stands out. It definitely has some pop to it, and there's a very nice smooth transition between the two patterns. I think this is a really, really good look, and it definitely has some flavor. Okay, let's look at another example. In this next example, we have a periwinkle check shirt. The periwinkle is the dominant color of the shirt. Okay, The checks are small in scale, and the spacing between the checks is small. Now I'm gonna use this tie that we looked at earlier, the navy blue and periwinkle check tie. And the scale of the checks in the tie and the scale of the checks in the shirt is small. So there's no varying range there. Also, the spacing between the checks and the tie and the spacing between the checks and the shirt is small. So there's no variation of size or spacing between the two items, and thus we have some vibration going on. It's a little hard on the eyes. Now, I've seen fellas do this, and certainly it's not enough to make you puke, but I'm always thinking, when I see this, I'm thinking in my head, okay, he could have done that a lot better. So let's take a look at a different tie. All right, now this tie has tiny polka dots, and the polka dots are, the spacing between the polka dots is very, very small. So there is a varying range between spacing and scale for the two items. This is small polka dots, small spacing. Small checks, small spacing. This is tiny polka dots, tiny spacing. So we've got a really nice transition going on there. Now it's a pretty conservative look. Definitely would work in a financial institution or legal, the legal industry. But it's I like it. I think it's a great look. So that concludes this two-part series on pattern mixing. Thanks so much for stopping by. I want to remind you about the giveaway. Don't forget, 50 subscribers. One lucky winner is going to win this Style Naturally beauty publication. Also, guess what, fellas? There is a prize out there just for you as well. One lucky guy is going to win a designer shirt and tie ensemble valued at $150 and selected just with you in mind. But you have to subscribe. You have to subscribe, and we still need to get to 50. So, if that isn't any incentive for you to subscribe, I don't know what is. And also, I've been getting some really, really great comments via Twitter and Facebook, and I'm very appreciative of those comments. But guys, can you just like put that on the YouTube channel as well? That would just be really, really, really awesome. And subscribe while you're there. Okay? So that's all I got for you today. I want to thank you for stopping by. This is your color girl, Indigo Zuri, and I'll see you next time. Peace.